and she's given the mic. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Today our topic is leadership, the concept and different types or styles of leadership. Okay, when we think of leaders, immediately the persons that come to our mind are Mahatma Gandhi, Subhash Chandra Bose, Dr. Radhakrishnan, Nelson Mandela, Abraham Lincoln, and the names of such persons. What is the common to all these persons? Can anyone say? What is common to these persons? The common quality is their good leadership. So, who is a leader?
Leader
is a person who influences a group of people towards the achievement of a goal. So, leader is a person who leads or motivates a group of people for achieving a goal. This group and the leader have some goals, and leader influences the persons or motivates the people to achieve the goal. That person is the leader. So what is leadership? Leadership is the process of inspiring a number of people or teams to behave and take action in a distinctive manner in order to accomplish very specific targets. Leader is the person who influences a group of people, and leadership is the process of inspiring. It's the process of inspiring a number of people or teams for what? To behave or to take action in a specific way, in a distinctive manner, for what? To accomplish very specific targets. There are so many definitions for this leadership, and is given by different persons. I have noted one or two definitions here. A definition of leadership given by Hannigan in 2002. According to Hannigan, leadership is the process of motivating other people to act in particular ways in order to achieve specific goals. It's the process of motivating other people. Leading or guiding or motivating or influencing a group of people to act in particular ways. They are motivated to act in particular ways for achieving specific goals. Another definition given by Alan Kate in 2009, which states that leadership is ultimately about creating a way for people to contribute to make something extraordinary happen. Leadership is ultimately about creating a way for people to contribute to make something extraordinary happen. Its leader is not a common man. Leader is a person who is extraordinary. So leadership is the process of creating a way for the group of people. For what? To contribute. For making something extraordinary happen. This leadership is defined in the contemporary settings. This definition was developed in 2003. In the contemporary settings, leadership can be defined as, it is a dynamic relationship based on mutual influence and common purpose between leaders and collaborators, in which both are moved to higher level of motivation and moral development as they affect real intended change. There are four aspects in this definition. There is a dynamic relationship. In this leadership, there are four aspects. There is a dynamic relationship that is based on what? Mutual influence. Dynamic relationship is there. A mutual influence is there. And there is a common purpose. Common purpose and collaborators. Collaborators means the group of people. each one can be explained like this. So there are four aspects in the this definition. The first one is the relationship. Relationship means it's the connection between the leader and the people in close proximity. Relationship is the connection between the leader and the group of people. Mutual influence. Mutual influence means the leader influences the group of people and the leader is influenced by these people. So they are influenced mutually. And there's a common purpose. And for that common purpose, the leader is standing for and the group of people is standing for. Collaborators are the those persons who work or cooperate with the leader for achieving the goal. This is the contemporary definition of leadership. It's dynamic relationship based on mutual influence and common purpose between leaders and collaborators in which both are motivated, both are moved to higher levels of motivation and moral development as they affect the real intended change. So in a leadership process, there is a relationship between leader and the collaborators and there is a mutual influence between leader and the group members and they have a common purpose and the collaborators are the group of people following that leader. Next, we move to leadership styles. There are different styles or types of leadership styles. So now we have seen what's leadership. Now we are moving to different styles of leadership. Okay. By leadership style, we mean they are the philosophies of leadership that guide the actions of the leader. Leadership style is the philosophies that guide the actions of the leader. These leadership styles are based on the culture, values, and the leader's own personal character traits. Based on culture, based on values, and based on leader's own personal character traits, different styles or types of leadership is there. And these leadership is determined by these leadership are the philosophies of the leadership style means the philosophies of leadership. And based on that philosophy, the actions of the leader works out. Some elements of leadership styles are often combined in the same person as it is rare for a leader to neatly fit into one category. There are different leadership styles are there and each leadership style has its own characteristics. But in one person, we can see the elements of different leadership styles. Because it is very difficult for a person to fit into one category always. So a leader may adopt different leadership styles at different contexts. So leadership styles are the philosophies of leadership and these leadership styles are based on the culture, values and leader's own personal character and the characters of different leadership styles may be combined in the same person because it is very difficult for a person to fit exactly into one category always. Now, let's look which are the different leadership styles. So many leadership styles are there. Now, we are discussing about 7 commonly used leadership styles. Can anyone read these leadership styles? Tinu, can you read?
Autocratic leadership, democratic leadership, laissez-faire leadership, transformational leadership, transactional leadership, servant leadership, situational leadership.
So these are the 7 leadership styles. Autocratic leadership, democratic leadership, laissez-faire leadership, transformational leadership, transactional leadership, servant leadership, and situational leadership. We are discussing about these 7 types of leadership in this session. Let us look one by one. The first one is autocratic leadership style. From the name itself, you can understand what is an autocratic leadership style. What will be the characteristic of autocratic leadership style? Alina? Can you say which are the characteristics of autocratic leadership style? From the name itself, it will be clear. Or who is an autocratic leader? What will be his characteristics? Alina. Leader is the authority. In this style of leadership, leader is holding the complete power and authority. Leader is the authority in autocratic style of leadership. In this style, leader is making all decisions. He do not entertain the suggestions from others. Group members have no provision to give their suggestions. Leader is not entertaining such suggestions from the group members. All the decisions are taken by the leader himself. In autocratic style of leadership, decision making is very fast because one person is deciding for the whole group. So they can take decision very fast. And the leader dictates all the works, methods and processes. How they have to do, when they have to do, everything is dictated by the leader, and the group members have to just follow this dictation or his instructions. So this is a directive leadership style. For autocratic leadership style, the complete authority, complete power is concentrated or centralized in one person. Leader is the authority. He do not entertain discussions. He do not entertain suggestions from the group members. He is taking all the decisions for everyone. And the followers has to follow his decisions. This is the autocratic style of leadership. Can you say the name of such autocratic leaders? Can you identify some autocratic leaders? Anjali?
Anjali,
Devan. Natural science. Okay. Can you say
Hitler is an
autocratic leader. North Korean president Kim Jong Un, he is an autocratic leader. Donald Trump, even if it is a democratic country, he is an autocratic leader sometimes. Not sometimes, most of the time he is an autocratic leader. In educational situation, can we adopt this autocratic leadership style?
No.
Anjali Rose, what's your opinion?
Democratic
But in small classes, we cannot entertain suggestions from the students. LKG, UKG, first standard. Can we expect any suggestions from the students? Here, teacher is deciding everything. Autocratic is not always a rude way of behavior, rude way of leadership. That can be friendly also. Leader is taking the decision. Leader is deciding what they have to do. So, in small classes, we can adopt this autocratic leadership style. Okay, so let's look what are the advantages of this autocratic leadership style. Leadership style. Here, the decision is faster. Why? Because the leader is taking the decision. There is no discussion, so he can take the decision in a faster way. The commonly used autocratic leadership is commonly used in situations where control is necessary. When complete control is necessary, we can adopt this autocratic leadership style. can be used to avoid a social dilemma. Not to avoid confusion or social dilemma, we can adopt this autocratic leadership style. Autocratic leadership style is not always bad. It has some positive sides when we need a control, or when in order to avoid some confusion or social dilemma, we can use this style. When we need to take an immediate decision, this autocratic leadership style is good. The autocratic leader can take very good decisions. That depends upon the nature of the leader. He can take very pleasant decisions, very friendly decisions, but he himself is taking the decision. Its negative sides are the subordinates become tense, the dependent, etc. If the leader is autocratic, the subordinates become tense. They have some sort of fear, they have tension or times, and they will become dependent to the leader because there is no provision for them to give suggestions. So they always become dependent to the leader. Leader is taking decisions for them, so they become dependent. Another negative side is there is no input from the group members. Since there is no discussion is promoted, the group members have no words to say. There is no provision for them to say. So there is, we cannot expect anything from the group members. Also, there is no trust on the members. Leader is taking the decision. Leader is not welcoming any suggestion from the group members. There is, so there may not be a relationship based on trust. There is no trust on the group members. So group members can become unhappy. That is another negative side of this autocratic leadership. If the leader is autocratic and if the decisions are not for the good of the group members, then group members may become unhappy. This is another disadvantage or negative side of this autocratic style. And there is no provision for the development of collaborators. They do not have the provision to explore their creativity. They do not have the provision for independent thinking. So that will not help for the development of the group members. That is another negative side of this autocratic leadership style. So what is an autocratic leadership style? Here, the complete power or authority is the leader. He is taking all the decisions, and he do not entertain suggestions or discussions from the group members, and the decision making is very fast, and the leader dictates all the work. And complete authority is on one person, and it has its own positive and negative aspects. Here, the decisions are very faster since one person is taking the decision, so decisions can be taken immediately, and it is mainly commonly used in situations where control is necessary or in order to avoid some social dilemma. And the negative sides are subordinates become tense, dependent, and there is no input for the group members. There is no trust on the group members. Group members can become unhappy, and there is no provision for the development of group members. In educational situation, this style can be adopted in lower classes and higher classes also, and sometimes in order to avoid some confusion or in order to create some control over the students, a teacher can become an autocratic leader in some situations, not always. Okay, clear. So the next style of leadership, democratic leadership. Can anyone say who is a democratic leader, or what will be the characteristics of a democratic leadership? Rufin, can you say?
Democratic rainbow group members in suggestion importance kodukkan korchu kuda encourage cheyyunnayirikkum pinne ellavarudeyum suggestions group members inte suggestions chodikkum ibide nu parayumbam ഗ്രൂപ്പ് ലീഡർ മാത്രമായിരിക്കില്ല ഗ്രൂപ്പ് മെമ്പേഴ്സിന്റെ ഇൻവോൾവ്മെന്റും കൂടെ ഉണ്ടായിരിക്കും.
In democratic leadership style, there is a cooperative relationship between the group leader and the group members. There's open communication between us. Leader is always communicating with the group members also. They encourage the this democratic leadership. Leader encourage suggestions from the group members. They are welcoming the suggestion. Group discussions are promoted and asked for the suggestions from the members and finally go for a collective decision. Here, the leader has some trust in his collaborators. This is the characteristic of democratic leadership. Our country is a democratic country. Even we can say that in this situation, in the situation of corona threat, our prime minister is conducting some discussion with the chief ministers of different states in order to take a decision for extending the lockdown. He is conducting a video conference with the the collaborators. Collaborators are the chief ministers of different states. Even if our chief minister and prime minister are autocratic leaders, to some extent they are autocratic. In some situations they are autocratic, but they have to be democratic because our country or our state is a democratic state. So they have to be democratic. They have to conduct discussion. They have to encourage or they have to seek for the suggestions from the other agencies or other his collaborators, etc. But they may show autocratic leadership, but sometimes. But since it is a democratic country and or democratic state, they have to be democratic to some extent. Before taking a decision, they are asking for suggestions and go for a collective decision. This is democratic. In democratic state, we are welcoming the leader is welcoming suggestions from the group members, and finally the decision is taken by the leader. He goes for a collective decision, and that decision is emerged from the suggestions of the group members. In educational situation, democratic leadership can be adopted in higher classes. In higher classes, teacher can be a democratic leader. He can ask for the suggestions or discussion of his students. That can be possible in higher classes. Finally, the teacher is taking decisions, but he will encourage discussions or suggestions for the suggestions from the students. So, which are the positives of this democratic state? It encourages creativity. It strengthens the relationship between the leader and the group members. It encourages commitment from the part of the collaborators. It encourages mutual trust. That is, leader has a trust in his collaborators and collaborators trust their leader also. There is a mutual trust. It promotes independent thinking. So there is provision for creativity. The members or followers has the provision to think independently. So definitely creativity will develop. The negative aspects: it does not always guarantee for best solution. Since everyone is giving their own suggestion, it does not always guarantee for a final, a best solution. And sometimes the solution may be bad. It leads to delay in decision making. Since the leader is taking decisions after analyzing the suggestions or after welcoming or welcoming the suggestions from the group members and after conducting many more discussions, so it may take a delay. It may create delay in decision making. And also sometimes the members can question the capabilities of leadership. In democratic country, we can see that our opposition leader or media persons or even the fellow beings or the common men question the capabilities of the leader. But we can see in every aspect, in democratic situation, the members can question the capabilities of the leadership. But in autocratic, there is no provision to question the abilities or capabilities of the leader. Another negative aspect is that it encourages no one to take the responsibilities of failure. Since the decision is coming from the discussions or suggestions from the group members, no one is ready to take the responsibility of failure. If the solution is a failure, if the decision is a failure, then no one will take the responsibility. At sometimes, the leader may say the group members are suggesting this, and the group members may say leader is taking the decision. No one is taking the responsibility of failure. That is a negative aspect of this democratic leadership. So, can you say the democratic leadership in short, Shruti? The characteristics, positive and negative aspects.
No, Gandhiji.
Shruti.
No.
Can you say the
Gandhiji?
Gandhiji. Gandhiji is a democratic leader, but he has another leadership style that we will see later. Barack Obama is a democratic leader. Our political leaders are democratic because our country is a democratic one. So they have to be democratic. So this is democratic leadership style. Here the discussions are encouraged, suggestions are welcoming, and there's a mutual trust, mutual good relationship. That there's a strong relationship between leader and the members. It encourages creativity, but some negative aspects are also there. There's a delay in decision making. Sometimes the members may question the capability of the leader, and sometimes no one take the responsibility of failure. Okay, let's move to the next type of leadership. This meeting will end within 2 minutes, but you have to rejoin. Okay, when it is ended, you have to rejoin again. Okay, next is laissez-faire leadership style. The third one, laissez-faire leadership style. Can anyone say what's a laissez-faire leadership? Laissez-faire leadership. Gion, can you say what is laissez-faire leadership?
ലീഡറിന്റെ ഭാഗത്തുനിന്ന് വളരെ കുറച്ചൊരു ഗൈഡൻസ് കാണുന്നുള്ളായിരിക്കും. ഗ്രൂപ്പ് മെമ്പേഴ്സിന് കംപ്ലീറ്റ് ഒരു ഫ്രീഡം കാണും ഡിസിഷൻസ് എടുക്കാൻ വേണ്ടി. ലീഡേഴ്സ് അതിന്റെ ടൂൾസ് റിസോഴ്സ് മാത്രം പ്രൊവൈഡ് ചെയ്യുന്നുള്ളതായിരിക്കും. അതിന്റെ ഗ്രൂപ്പ് മെമ്പേഴ്സിന് കംപ്ലീറ്റ് എബിലിറ്റി കാണും ഡിസിഷൻ എടുക്കാനായിട്ട്.
Let's look at the characteristic. In laissez-faire leadership, the power is decentralized. The leader is giving power to the group members. In autocratic leadership, the complete power is centralized on the leader himself. In democratic leadership, the leader is taking decision, but he will welcome the suggestions of the group members. But in laissez-faire leadership, leader is giving complete freedom to the group members. They can decide. They can set their own goals. They can work for that. Very little guidance is from the part of the leader. Complete freedom is given to the group members to take the decision. The group members are taking decisions. They are solving their own problems. Leader will provide the tools and resources, and group members are expected to solve problems of their own. They are solving their own problems, and the power is handed over to the followers. But still, the leaders take the responsibility for the group's decisions and actions. This is laissez-faire leadership. Here, the group members have complete freedom. The power is decentralized to the group members. They can take their own decision. They have the provision to set their own goals and work for that. This is, but still, leader will take the responsibility of the group's decisions or actions. This is laissez-faire leadership style. This can be adopted in advertising agencies. This laissez-faire leadership style can be adopted only when the group members are self-motivated and skilled. Very skilled. If the group members are very skilled and self-motivated, this laissez-faire